Hi everyone, it's Adam from Dimebag Rib Project here. Hope you're all well. Today we're going to be going over the Metal Hammer Golden Gods Awards 2004 magazine spread featured with Nikki Sixx, Valo from him, and Dimebag Daryl. Now, funny story about this particular photo shoot that went on. Alongside the photo shoot, a program or channel over here in the UK called Sky One was filming an episode for a program they had called Limo Fever. Now, Limo Fever was an 8-episode series covering the escapades of limo drivers. So whether that be bachelor parties or hen do's or hiring rock stars, they kind of covered it. So, back in 2004, this episode was released. At the time, I was just finished school. I was flicking through late night TV and saw this particular episode. And I didn't think of anything until years later. Social media kicked in. And I still couldn't find this footage. And I asked around and no one knew what the hell I was on about. They thought I was crazy. And so I looked it up online. Couldn't find anything online. All I could find was the producers and editors' names. So I did a quick Google search on some of the names and found the editor that did the particular series. And his name's Cliff. So I messaged Cliff and said, "Hi, I'm a massive Dimebag Daryl fan. I'm trying to get some footage of a particular episode that you edited. Would you be able to find it? Do you have it?" He messaged me back and said, "Yes, I do have it. I have all 8 episodes still on DVD. Let me know what episode you want." So, "Sorry, mate, I don't know what episode it is. You might just have to send me it all and I'll try and find the episode that I need." He said, "Yeah, that's fine. I can send you all 8 episodes for X amount of money." And I thought, I don't really want to be spending that amount of money just to find, you know, a small bit of footage. So, I kind of put it on the top shelf and forgot about it for a few years. And then I messaged him again, probably back in 2017, 2018. So, about 5 years after I originally messaged him and 14 years after the original episode was aired as well. So, he said, "Yeah, I found the episode. And what I've done for you, mate, is I've put it into a mini episode for you. I'm going to charge you this amount for my time. And I've put Panda Post over the screen just so, you know, when you do buy it, that will be removed. But for copyright, because I've produced what I've produced, I'll send you it. Let me know what you think of it and then we'll go from there." So he sent me it, but I still couldn't justify spending, let's just say, over £100 on this particular video footage. So I thought I would upload it here and share it with you guys. Now, just before we go through the video that I'm going to upload for you, we're going to go through the magazine article and show you some of the features in there. Okay, so here we have the Metal Hammer 2004, August 2004. Now, as we go through this magazine, you can see we have the guys on this photo just here, as we're going to speak about in a minute. We've got a little spread here by Jamie Hibbard, who was actually in the episode as well. He arranged the limo and he actually arranged the episode being filmed with Sky One. So as we go through the magazine, we can see that there's a feature on the awards, starting from page one. So loads of photos, limo just there. Best guitarist, Dimebag Daryl, Nikki Sixx. Dimebag absolutely wasted. I think he was on a 3-day bender when he was in the UK, where he'd be playing the show at the Astoria Download Festival and doing this piece just here. And obviously we've got a full article just here on the guys going out doing this particular photo shoot as well. So you can find yourself one of these magazines on eBay. They go for anything between £3 and £5. Maybe even £6 or £7, depending when you look, and depending on condition as well, whether it comes with a CD or if it's frayed or any cuttings have been taken out, I don't know. But yeah, I paid about £4 for this magazine. The original price was about £3.75. So yeah, it's a good little read. There's you could win a Dimebag signed Washburn 333 feature in there as well. And there's also a feature of the Damage Plan show, which is with the London Astoria in 2004 as well. So let's get on with the video. I hope you enjoy it. It is cringy in some points. But yeah, let me know what you think in the comments below. And I'll be back at the end of the video to just do a little recap.
...43-year-old Paul Miles is not your average limo driver.
So anyway, so I thought I'd just give this a little bit of a polish. You know, and I've got no polish with me, so I'm just going to give it a little bit of that. Must clean me tax disc.
The limo world's answer to David Brent, Paul runs his own company from his home in Bracknell. Today, Paul has one of his biggest jobs of the year. Lunchtime in London. Paul and chauffeur Fadi Nasri are heading for a pickup in their 100 grand military designed Hummer limousine. The limo is being featured in an exclusive cover photo shoot for a heavy metal music magazine.
This is a Hummer, it's a 200 stretch Hummer. This is the car of the moment, you know, this is what everybody wants to hire at the moment. This one is brand new, it's literally been registered less than a week. I think it was registered Thursday last week. It's one of the only ones that's got a half moon shaped seat in it that I've seen. It's got laser lights, it's got the disco ceiling, again, a very rare extra that you don't see on hardly any. This is the first one I've ever seen it in.
Today the boys can't be late. Their luxury limo has a date with rock royalty.
Yeah, we're going to the Metal Hammer Awards. I'm not sure what it's going to be like when we get there, but apparently there's going to be 1,500 kids there screaming. We're going to get as many groupers as we can in the back today because it should be a bit of fun. As long as they're young, fit and exciting. And I might even let some girls in as well. We've got a guy today called Nikki Sixx. Well, Nikki Sixx or Sixx, I'm not sure. I think he's in Motley Crue, and we've got some other guy from Dimage or Damage or some other group like that. Well, I'm not very good on heavy metal, it's not my scene, but I've been practicing all my movements all weekend, and I'm getting it half right. Yeah, Fadi, have you heard of Nikki Sixx?
Yeah.
Have you? Yeah, well, who is he then?
When he's not setting himself on fire, ex-Motley Crue bassist Nikki Sixx lives the ultimate rock lifestyle. He's done groupies, he's done overdoses, he's even concussed band member Tommy Lee. His proudest moment was receiving an adrenaline injection to his heart. It saved his life, but did it save his brain? At the awards venue, magazine editor Jamie Hibbard is organising the photo shoot. As well as metal god Nikki, he's invited other tattooed men with ridiculous names, including him frontman Vili Vallo, an ex-Pantera rocker, Dimebag Daryl.
It's a cover shoot and we've got three of the biggest rock stars in the world coming down to be shot for it. So I've got to find a nice balance of keeping them happy but also getting them to do what you want to do. And I don't want to annoy them.
Jamie's getting nervous, but will Paul rock up for his temperamental rock stars on time? Across town, Paul and Fadi are experiencing a common yet not surprising problem. 38-foot stretched Hummers and cramped London streets don't mix. They're late and they're lost.
Well, I better tell you what, we better just check. Do you think we're going the right way? We're just a little bit behind schedule. Just go straight on, mate. Just go where you think you should be going. I think that's probably the safest bet. I'll just program in Mare Street, just to be sure. It's giving me a lot of French names, which is not what I want. Right, stick that on the dash, Fadi, and it'll do it for you, mate. These are always the problems with the real big vehicles. They're very, very difficult to negotiate. A lot of these streets obviously don't cater for anything this side, and because they're long and rigid, the turning circles on them are appalling. And to be honest, the turning circle on a normal Hummer is pretty terrible. So when you've got a stretched one, it is a bloody nightmare to negotiate. Look at this turning. Oh my God, you've got no chance of getting around there, Fadi. He's got more chance of being an astronaut than getting around this bend. Are you right there, Captain Cook?
With the traffic getting worse, Paul and Faddy are in danger of missing their rendezvous with rock god Nikki Sixx, apparently a man whose hobby is punching out his friends. It's little wonder editor and Seven Stone weakling Jamie is getting twitchy. Coming up, Paul is shattered by heavy metal tough guys. In central London, limo boss Paul is running late for the magazine awards where his stretch Hummer limousine is booked for a cover shoot with ex-Motley Crue rock legend Nikki Sixx.
We've had a little bit of a mare getting to Mare Street. But the actual magazine that's booked us, I think they'll probably be getting quite frustrated at this stage because we're now 25 minutes late, even though we've been less than half a mile from here for the last 45 minutes. We've now turned down this road and it is a dead end. So we are going to have some right fun now getting out of this road.
If Paul doesn't rock up soon, magazine editor Jamie will be forced to give him the axe.
I think what we'll do, Faddy, just wait a minute, we'll jump out and we'll block the road, all right? Okay, here we go. Watch your backs.
Navigating city streets is difficult enough in small cars, but in a 38-foot limousine, it borders on the ridiculous.
All right, keep going.
Luckily, Paul and Faddy are deft hands at limo limbo.
Go ahead.
Paul's expert manoeuvring skills have got the Hummer back on track, but further behind the clock. Over 40 minutes late, they arrive at their destination. Well, Paul does, anyway.
What a nightmare. This has got to be the hardest place to bring a Hummer limo in the whole of the country. And now we're here, we can't park. It's a bloody nightmare, I tell you.
While Faddy looks for the elusive 38-foot long parking space, Paul makes his excuses to Metal Hammer editor Jamie.
Nice to meet you, mate. Yeah, we've had nightmares getting here, mate. Absolute nightmares. The roads are so small, mate, we just couldn't get the car around.
Yeah.
I've had so much stress in my life, mate. I've got a small penis and everything, so, you know, I just have to live with it.
That's why you got a big car.
That's it. That's the only reason. mate. I can't pull the birds any other way. 43 fat balding, I've got no chance.
This is ridiculous.
It's good, though, isn't it? Can you imagine the groupies in there, Jamie?
Yeah.
Quality, innit? Come on, girls, look, mirrored ceiling. This is the life, innit? Hey? This is the only chance I've got of getting laid on the job.
You got enough room?
Yeah,
you get a few groupies.
It's quality, innit, man? I think they'll like it, it's a bit of a...
It's good.
Having passed the all-important, is it suitable for shagging a groupie while I vomit test, all Paul's limo needs now is rock god Nikki Sixx to sit in it. Not that Paul would notice.
I've got to be honest, I wouldn't have a clue. I wouldn't even know if he walked past me. Obviously, because I'm not into heavy metal, he'd probably just walk past me now and everyone would go, well, there he is, and I'd go, where? And he'd be cleaning the road or something, I wouldn't know.
With no stars in sight, rock photographer Mick needs a stand-in for a test shot. Editor Jamie has the perfect solution.
You should do a test shot with him, and then he can have it for his website.
Good thinking, Sam. I like that one.
So we need three together. We need a gold star.
I didn't think I'd be excited, but I'm definitely getting a twinge now. So they're going to do a test shoot. They want me to go inside, so they're just going to test the lighting and all that sort of stuff.
Have you got any rock star poses?
I don't know, mate. I'm going to do my best, you know, like give it. I don't know. Rock star stuff, they stick all the tongues out. It's not really me.
Hello.
Lights, camera, and Paul go straight into action.
Yeah, I mean, it's pretty good. I'm just waiting for my next number one to come out. You know, next week, we've got a few groupies outside. Leave it out, girls, no signatures. But, you know, I'm enjoying it, you know what I mean? A few groupies. I can't believe I'm just a driver. I should be famous.
As Paul's newfound fame goes to his head, there's not a rock god in sight, and the Hummer's about to go into overtime and extra costs. Twitchy Jamie is getting twitchier. At the Metal Hammer Awards in London, metal god Nikki Sixx has finally arrived. But will he impress our Paul?
He's not a cool geezer.
Yeah, seems alright.
Good hair, dude. What the hair, dude? Is he pleased to see me?
Nikki Sixx.
Nikki Sixx.
Sixx.
Sixx. No, Sixx. I'll get it right in a minute, will I? I'll get it right in a minute.
Even though he's over 1 hour late, hard man Nikki isn't ready for his close-up. Paul thinks he can use some inside influence to get him moving.
We don't know if he's had a pretty heavy night last night, but I'll put in a good word for you.
Yeah, it shouldn't be a problem, should it?
I'll use my persuasive charms and get you in. What was that, Nikki? Oh, yeah, you can. Yeah, he's just telling me now. God, that's a bit of luck, isn't it? In my ear, you mean?
Ex-Pantera guitarist Dimebag Darrell has also arrived, but, surprise, surprise, he appears to have overindulged.
Yeah, you can see the kind of gig it is because everyone's issued with a special pass, and they're all members of the Alcoholic Anonymous Club, which is on there, look. And, you know, I think we'll put a few bottles of champagne in there just for fun and see what happens.
With a Hummer under threat from several hundred metal maniacs, it's time for Paul to take Rock's royalty off to the secret photo location. Once a bad boy millionaire rock star, always a bad boy millionaire rock star. But if the bad boys get really bad, editor Jamie could end up with the biggest bill of his career. And Paul's £100,000 Hummer could be heading straight for the scrap heap. In London, limo boss Paul Miles is chauffeuring ex-Motley crew member Nikki Sixx and fellow legends of rock to the Metal Hammer photo shoot. The rock stars are making an unscheduled makeover of the £100,000 Hummer's interior. They've also discovered Paul's crystal. Oops.
We don't mind. Yeah, only 10 grand a glass, real crystal.
I'm never having this idea ever again. It's the stupid one of my career.
Stupid ideas don't really matter when it's not your vehicle. Lucky, it's a short journey.
We were just checking the damage because they obviously like smashing glasses, which we didn't know they were going to do, and spitting champagne all over the carpet. It's not really very nice from a limousine hire point of view, but I'm sure they'll pay the valet in charge, so I don't suppose it matters too much. I wish I knew they were going to do that. I could have put the old cheap breakable ones in there, do you know what I mean? That's rock, innit, I suppose. Oh, I said no problem.
Come on, bitch! Let's go!
You get to sit on the bonnet if you want.
Good.
Deeply intellectual one-liners and giving the fingers is all part of the well-rehearsed, anger-ridden world of heavy metal hard men. But there's a problem. These dark lords are hungry for chaos. They want to donut the Hummer, spinning the car in circles with your foot flat to the floor. Paul's 100 grand limo still has the keys in the ignition.
He's just asked if you do a donut in it. I said, I don't think you'd be able to do one in that summer. Jamie, he's talking about doing a donut. You better tell him he ain't insured in that if he
well,
goes anywhere.
Tell him, it's your car. Man. Yeah, wrong
with you're not insured in it, guys, so don't try driving it because we could be in big trouble, right?
All right.
You don't trust him that much?
No, not at all.
Okay.
They're rock stars. Why would you trust them in your limo with the keys in it? Just lean in and take it out.
Okay. On your instructions, I'll do it then. All right, how's that? There you go. For safety's sake, I was told to remove the keys. Because.
Ooh. It's a hard jump right there.
The donut crisis seems to have been avoided. But as this man takes the wheel, one suspects that even if the keys were in it, he wouldn't know what to do with them. But then again, this is rock and roll.
There's a good chance there's a reason behind
it. Anyway, I'm just a bit worried about Don because he's wasted and might do something crazy. But then this is rock and roll, so what did I expect?
One, two, three. Perfect.
Let's go.
Photo shoot over. At last, it's a chance to hear some wisdom from a real rock god.
Cool, man. Just another day in rock and roll.
I should get on.
Another tame day in rock and roll.
So does London rock this summer?
I've never felt it like this here before.
Yeah, he's hot, man.
The girls always have hairy pussies and it's always raining and now it's like nice and nice there too.
And shaving ravens.
What's with that?
With the last up yours, the mission's completed and it's time for Paul to return the gods of metal back to base and for the hard men to bid each other a soft farewell.
You'll be fine, trust me, you'll be fine.
Love you, bro. Love you, man.
It's a sweet metal moment, but will the lowly chauffeur get the same treatment?
Listen, we're going. Thank you, guys. Shake his hand, look. Nikki, I'm going.
You'd be into it?
Totally into it.
You don't.
Thank you, Nikki.
Thank you very much.
Okay.
Better than a poke in the eye with a sharp stick.
Thanks for that. Take care. Yeah, have a good gig. All right, that's it. All done. Dusted. Sorted.
Job over. Paul has survived his heavy metal induction, and the Hummer will live to see another day. Long live rock and roll.
What did you think? Cringy, I know. When the limo driver calls Nikki Sixx Nikki Sticks, when he calls Damage Plan Dimage. All round cheese TV, I think. Thank you for Cliff for putting that mini episode for me together, so that I can share it out there with you guys. Let me know what you think in the comments below. I'm trying to get hold of Metal Hammer UK to see if they've got footage of the award ceremony that happened in 2004, because from what I'm led to believe, it was absolute chaos. And as we mentioned earlier, Dimebag was on a 3-day session. I think he played Download on the Sunday, he played the Astoria on the Tuesday, and then the award ceremony was within a couple of days after that, and the whole time he was drinking. So yeah, the last time Dime was in the UK, as you saw at the end of the video as well, Dime was hugging Nikki Sixx goodbye and saying he loves him. And that's probably the last time Nikki probably saw Dimebag as well, so it was nice to watch and capture that moment as well. But yeah, let me know what you think in the comments below, guys. I'm going to do an outro with a few pictures from the photo shoot. Hope you enjoyed it. Hit subscribe, follow me on Instagram, dimebag_rig_project, and I'll see you soon.